Welcome to Python series. In this video, we are going to see the use of global keyword. So in this program, we have used it here, as you can see, inside our function. And we will see what is the use of this global keyword and what will happen to this program if we delete this global line altogether. So what difference does it make to our program? Let us see by this program. And before I start explaining, let us understand what this whole program is all about. So what we are doing here in this program is we are asking the user to enter the number of apples he is buying. Okay, so this is the input statement. So this will prompt the user to enter a value. As you can see in the output, the program is asking the user to enter number of apples, which has been entered as 11. Next, the program compares if the number of apples entered are more than 10 or not. So if it is more than 10, then you can see that we are calling our function here, rate, which is defined here. Okay, so if the apples are more than 10, the program enters in our function. And if they are less than 10, the else loop will execute and the cost will be calculated. So what is the use of this function is that we are trying to give a discount to the user. If he buys more than 10 apples, the program enters into this function, which will apply a discount of 20 rupees here. So the cost is reduced by 20 and the final bill is calculated here, which is returned, and you can see it is printed. So you are seeing the output. Your bill is rupees, so it is printed from this line. Okay, whatever is saved in S is calculated in the function, so we get the output. And finally, in the last line, rate per item. That means we are showing the customer what rate was applied. So you can see that the rate applied was 80, which is a discounted rate, because the global cost was 100. It is global because it is defined outside the function. So this is a global variable. So let us run this program again and see what will happen if we enter number of apples which is less than 10. Let's say 5. So the bill is 500 because the rate applied was 100. The rate of 100 is applied because the apples are, of course, less than 10. So the program is running in else loop, which is using the original cost of 100 rupees, and it is displayed here. The rate per item was 100. So the bill was 500 for 5 apples. So what is the use of global here? Let's delete it and see what difference will be there in the program. Let's comment it out instead of deleting it, so that will not run this line. Let's run the program again and enter 5. So again, we are seeing the same result, 500 and 100, because the program is not going into the function loop. Let's run the program again and this time enter something more than 10. Let's say 12. So now we are getting the bill of 960, which is correct, but the rate per item, it is displayed as 100, which is wrong because we are now using the rate 80, which should be displayed. So what happened when we remove this global keyword? The cost is not changed. The cost which we print here is not changed. It is again displayed as 100. So what our global keyword is doing, that it is changing this cost variable globally. It is changed for the whole program. So the global keyword, what it does, it changes the value of your global variable for the whole program. So we can make this program without using this global keyword and make it work right. So that will be the most appropriate method in this case, and one should avoid the use of global keyword because it changes the value globally, which is not desired in most of the cases. So that is all for this video. Hope you have enjoyed learning. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.